Hi everyone, welcome to today's Cynerio Rapid Recap. Today we're going to talk about the Apache Log4j vulnerability that's been all over the web all weekend and help healthcare providers figure out how to best address this issue. A little bit of an overview to start off if you don't know what Log4j is. It's an open source Java logging library. It's been used for over 20 years now. It's pretty much an industry standard. It's one of six or seven different libraries that are widely used. It's being open source doesn't necessarily make it more vulnerable, but it does make it a little easier to fix, which is kind of nice, and we're seeing the results of that. And if you want to learn more about the specific projects, its uses, its functionality, etc., you can always go to the Apache website there. Also has some good information about the vulnerability that was identified. More importantly, over the weekend, Log4j has got a lot of attention in the news. A vulnerability came out called Log4Shell. This vulnerability was identified back in late November. It was actually identified by Alibaba's cloud security team in Minecraft. So one of the interesting things about open source projects like this is that they're used through all kinds of systems. In this case, thousands and thousands of systems, including games like Minecraft. And after some additional research by the Apache organization, they came out on December 9th, so late last week, and made a public disclosure about it. The issue allows for arbitrary code execution, which I'll talk about in just a second, and has the highest CVSS score of 10.0 you can get. To summarize all that pretty easily, Amit Yoren from Tenable, the CEO over there, has probably the most accurate quote. It's the single biggest, most critical vulnerability of the last decade. Effectively, it hits thousands and thousands and thousands of websites and puts them in incredibly high risk of breach. So the why is this bad is pretty obvious, but it's an industry standard used by tens of thousands, if not hundreds and millions of systems. So it can range from Minecraft to iCloud to Red Hat systems to Cisco. You know, anything you're using that uses some kind of Java underpinnings is likely to be affected by this in some way. Additionally, the attack is very, very simple. You can see an attack string, an example attack string that I've written out there. It can just effectively be throwing that in a Minecraft chat server or throwing it in an input field, having some malicious code at the address that is referenced there, and boom, you're stealing data, you're taking systems down, you're installing ransomware, whatever the case may be. So it seems that nearly everyone is impacted, right? If you look at Red Hat, my favorite former employer, they have a huge amount of Java onto their systems, which could impact this. And that, again, goes for hundreds and thousands of other companies out there. The more critical details, the versions that are impacted are 2.0-beta 9 through 2.14.1 inclusive. So an incredibly wide range of Log4j versions are impacted. If you want to read more about the CVE, there's a link there. There's all kinds of resources. So if you Google, you're going to find a bunch. To figure out if you're at risk, it's pretty straightforward. Identify your Java systems and check for the Log4j versions. If they're in that range up above, you're going to be vulnerable to this attack. The good news is, and one of the huge benefits of this being an open source library, is that there is a new version, 2.15.0, that is now available that fixes this issue. There's some other patches for older versions as well that you can find out there. But do know that if you are vulnerable to this attack, you can update your library, test it, and roll it out. And of course, we're seeing a lot of people struggle with this. We're finding that people are struggling to identify all their Java systems, find out how to patch it, test those patches, etc. So if you want to read more about this, you can see the Cynerio blog post link on this here. You can scan the QR code to go to our website, or more importantly, you can reach out to us directly. You know, reach out if you're a healthcare system, you're working to address this at support@cynerio.com. How we're going to help you is a couple different things. First, we're going to work on your devices. That's what Cynerio does. We focus on device security in healthcare environments. So any device that has this vulnerability, we're going to locate it, we're going to flag it, and we're going to monitor it over time. We're also going to be in constant contact with the vendors to identify fixes. So today, we'll start monitoring your systems, make sure if attack comes through, we're going to minimize that attack, make sure it doesn't spread. And then as vendors start to fix those, we're going to make sure that you get notified of those fixes. We're also going to help you with mitigation plans. We're going to give you step-by-step actions you can take to start addressing this today. As well as links to advisories and manufacturers. So we're going to do all that work for collecting this information, as well as help you through the mitigations, you know, within hours in some cases. We'll give you patch release notifications as they come out, and then we'll figure out how to protect against this and other attacks going forward by defining zero trust policies, streamlining segmentation, and then monitoring, testing, validating, and updating those policies before they're enforced. Effectively, we don't want the functional aspects of your medical devices to go down as we're protecting them as well. So if you have questions, reach out to Cynerio. You'll find us on every major professional social network. We're Cynerio.com. My name is Chad Holmes, chad.holmes@Cynerio as well. But this is an incredibly nasty vulnerability. You have to start addressing it today, or you're going to be, or you already are at risk of a massive attack. Good luck. Let us know how you can help. Have a great day.